you, of all people, would be such a chauvinist.
I'm not a chauvinist. I'm an anarchist.
You're a pig.
Your words, not mine.
I'm no longer interesting because I'm a mother is probably the most gender-biased thing that I have ever heard.
It's merely an observation.
And it's a terrible one. We all know that domesticity is something you find abhorrent.
Well, I certainly do.
Well, some of us don't. In fact, some of us enjoy it, and it's not because we're women or because we're mothers. It's because we like family. We like security and stability.
You like the nest.
I wouldn't go that far.
Look, it's not that this doesn't happen to men. Sometimes it does. It just doesn't happen as often or as radically. I've never seen a man take his life and completely go 180 degrees just because he became a father.
So it's estrogen. Is that what you're saying?
Well, what do you think it is?
How about growing up? How about it's called, I'm not the center of the universe anymore? How about it's called, if I choose to have a kid, the implication is that I put that kid's needs first? You have to help them make choices. You have to support them. You have to help them not make bad choices that will affect the rest of their lives.
Natasha, good choices or bad choices, it's all the same. We are the sum total of every choice we make. That's called life. One night last spring, I made a choice to cut across town. Down Lexington. And that choice changed my life forever and ended a four-year-old's.
Luke, what happened to Jake was an accident. It was a random thing.
Look, my point is that my kids are going to make good and bad choices. I hope they don't make as bad a choice as that one. But whatever choices they make, they have to live with the consequences. And only they can live with the consequences. I can't change it. I am only in charge of my life.
That doesn't mean that as a parent, you can't help them, you can't support them, that you can't try to make their life better than your own. Came out last year, that woman. She had these unrealistic expectations of her kids, right? You know, she wanted them to do piano for 4 hours, and they were only three. Then she wanted them to learn multiple languages at four, and she wanted them on the college track before they even got out of nursery school.
Which one of them slit her throat? Or did they kill each other?
Exactly. See, this woman had some issues. She thought that her children were extensions of herself, and she thought their excellence was a reflection of her. Pathological narcissist. See, that's the opposite kind of narcissist that you are, and I think I fall somewhere in the middle.
Oh, sure you do.
I am nothing like that woman. I know that I can't live my children's lives, and I know that at some point I'm going to have to let them go, but I'm never going to stop wanting what's best for them or trying to guide them.
Well, as a middle-of-the-road narcissist, that's your prerogative.
Thank you. See? Look how well I did with Sam. She married a mobster. Did I say no? Did I try to stop it? No. Follow her heart. I was happy for her.
Well, Sam's a grown woman. Probably a grown woman with a limited life expectancy, given who she married. But nevertheless, her life is her own. And my kids, their lives are their own. If they want to settle down, if they want to hit the open road, if they want to be happy or miserable or drunk or sober, if they want to be nuns and priests, if they want to be drug addicts, it's not up to me. I have nothing to do with it. It's their lives.
Then why are you here? If you don't give a damn, if you think they're all grown up and they're not your problem, why are you here, Luke? You are so full of it. You know that they need you, and you need them.